the wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. AS News. With the Tyson Fury, man, did he finally lose it or what?
What happened with him? I heard something happened. What happened with Tyson Fury?
He dressed up as Batman and he beat up the Joker. You think all those uppercuts he landed on himself finally got to him?
He's crazy, man.
Yeah. Does that give him a chance now, dressing up as Batman and going into the fight with some superhero abilities?
Not at all.
Chad, man, what's wrong with him? Why is Vladimir fighting Batman? I don't understand it.
Vladimir's a pod, man. That's all he do is fight pod.
Okay, Fury's undefeated, man. How do you stay undefeated and you're just a straight up weirdo like that, man? Like, what is it? How many pies did he fight to stay undefeated?
Well, the whole thing, he hasn't been busy. He hasn't been active, so I want to know how he's going to win this fight not being busy.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a guy, I'm 43 years old, I got a lot of experience. But he's a young guy who's not been busy. I'm wondering how he's going to be, you know, sharp.
Yeah. Hey, champ, how do you land uppercuts on yourself, man? I just don't get it. I mean.
That's right. How you doing, man?
Yeah, I'm doing good, man. How you doing, champ?
I'm good, brother. I be seeing all your work you be doing, man. You're a good dude, champ.
Nah, man, thanks to you, man. I've been a fan of yours, you know, for a long time, man. Just want to support the champ, you know?
I appreciate you, champ. I'm in.
Matisse versus Pistol. How do you see that fight?
Oh, man. You know, I'm looking forward to seeing that fight. He's a big guy, Tyson Fury. He's been around a while now. You know, he's had some good fights with Steve Cunningham as well as Derek Chisora. So I'm looking forward to seeing that fight. And once we can hopefully get it done. And next year, March, April.
So, you coming off a big win. How do you feel about your performance?
It was cool. It was great. It was, you know, I'm in shape. I'm in top shape. That's what I trained to do. Search and destroy. I went out there and searched him down. He got away out of the first round, but I caught him in a second.
How you feel about that confrontation you had with Vladimir Klitschko? What was that all about? How did that come about?
Because he is, you know, he imitated to be a champion, man.
Yeah.
I fought his brother with one arm.
Yeah.
I know they're not as tough as you think they are. So, you know, I'm prepared to win that title. That's what I've been prepping my mind for. That's what Let's Go Champ is all about. Let's Go Champ is like self-motivating, pushing yourself to a mantra. And that's what I've been saying for the last 2 years. Let's Go Champ. Let's Go Champ.
Champ, you had a lot of legends there supporting you. How does that feel, man? I know you reunited with Lennox Lewis.
Yes, that was amazing. I mean, just to be, you know, all of us to sit together in a ring and talk about old stories, it was a great thing, man. It was unbelievable. It was a great moment for us.
Yeah. How do you feel about Canelo versus Cotto? How do you see that fight playing? Oh, the Gallo Negro Washington, man, you just seen what the stunt that Fury pulled with Klitschko. What's your thoughts on it, man? Has he finally lost it or what?
I love it, man. I love the enthusiasm, man. He's great for boxing. He's a great character. You know, the sport needs a guy like that.
He's got the heavyweight division now on the spotlight, right, with those kind of antics?
Right. It's funny seeing a guy like him versus a guy like Klitschko. Klitschko is real conservative, and Tyson Fury jumped off the deep end with all the stunts and stuff. So it's real cool to see those guys match up together. Let's see. Klitschko said boxing is good therapy. Let's see if he could teach him something in the ring.
You think that's what's gonna give Tyson Fury some superhero abilities going into the fight?
Nah, man. Once you're in the ring, man, it's mano a mano, baby. It's all the tricks and all the gags that I left outside the ring, man. It's all about the hard work that you put in the gym. And I know Klitschko works hard, so we'll see if he can stand up to it.
Pullman, what do you think, man? It's overboard if you ask me. You think all those self-inflicted uppercuts he landed on himself finally got to him?
I don't know, man. I definitely think that Tyson Fury is like a really big talker and very flamboyant. Like Gerald said, he, maybe goes a little too far at times, but I mean, I thought it was pretty funny what he did with the Batman thing, but having said that, Tyson Fury's also a legitimate, really good fighter, too.
Yeah.
He's not just talking. Like, he's gonna come and he got skills, and he's big, and he's strong, and pretty fast, and pretty coordinated, and do a lot of different things in there. Klitschko's a champ for a reason.
What happens to a Zephyr, man, if he loses? If he loses, where does he go from there? I mean, doesn't he make him look stupid?
You're talking about Tyson Fury?
Yeah. Make him look stupid, right?
Yeah, I don't know, man.
I mean, if he loses, he'll be set for a job at Hollywood Boulevard, you know, with the Batman suit and all.
Yeah, I mean, he still, you know, he'll still be a legitimate, you know, tough fighter for anybody, though, you know. I think Tyson Fury's a real deal. I mean, I think Klitschko is... He thinks that he's getting Klitschko at a good time. I don't think Klitschko's that old.
Yeah.
I think Klitschko's a little bit older, but he's smart, very strong, and very experienced. So I'm looking for an explosive type fight.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekback. Take a step back. Back.